Hello, my name is Tim Bushnell, and I'm here today with an expert cytometry teaching point. Today's teaching point will be on quality control. Quality control is an essential component for quality reproducible data. It should not be left just to the individuals who are running the instrument. You should also consider quality control for your experiment. Now, we can think about a wide variety of ways to use beads, and one of the most important ways is to use them in quality control. As I said, quality control is essential for determining the instrument performance. This is going to tell you how the system is working and making sure that it's working day to day consistently. But you need to make sure you track this over time. If you just do quality control and don't track it, you're not actually performing quality control because you don't know how the system is changing. You can use the original equipment manufacturer's protocols, or you can develop your own protocol. You can buy beads like the QB Sure beads from Cytech, the Align Flow beads from Thermo Fisher. You should determine what is important to track. An example of a quality control program is here, the CS&T beads by BD. You can see we're tracking using a Levy-Jennings plot, and when there was a change in the bead lot, we saw a different change in the performance of the system. So we would need to characterize that. If you're developing your own quality control program, here's an example template that you might consider. So in this template, we include information about the beads that the template is being used for. You can see the bead name, the lot, and the expiration date of the beads. Next, you're going to indicate the target values for each of the different values that you're going to be measuring. In this case, we're looking at the median fluorescence intensity of different channels. We've drawn gates around those. And then, of course, we need to have our statistics and our quality control so we can monitor that. It's important not just to do instrument quality control, but to think about experimental quality control. For example, we can use a peak 6 bead or any bead that you like that's fluorescent in multiple channels. After you've identified the optimal voltage, every day you sit down to run your experiment, you run that bead standard with the target values. And then again, you track it over time. You can see this is a 100-day tracking of a sorting experiment. We're using the Levy-Jennings plot. This is the mean. These are plus or minus 1 and 2 standard deviations around the mean. You can establish your criteria for what would be failing based upon a wide variety of options. This is something that you have to determine for yourself. I recommend that if a value goes below 2 standard deviations, or you see something for 3 or 4 days in a row that's below or above 1 standard deviation, that you need to think about intervening in your system. Now, in addition to that, you can run reference controls. Reference controls are cells that perform in a defined way in your assay. This can include frozen PBMCs. This can include the Vera cells. These are lyophilized cells from BioLegend, or the Cytotrol cells, which are from Beckman Coulter, or any other control that you feel will reproduce the quality data, both performing how the staining works and how the assay performs. And here's an example of that type of data where we're looking at a wide variety of metrics, establishing a range that we would expect performance on these systems. And that allows us to track this over time to ensure that we have good quality in our data. This puts the effort not only on the people running the instruments, but also the people who are doing the experiments. To summarize this teaching point, beads are useful for many flow cytometry applications. We'll be talking about more of those in the future. Quality control is critical for ensuring consistency and reproducibility of data. Quality control helps identify issues before they become problems. Quality control is only useful if it is monitored on a regular basis. The Levy-Jennings plot is one way to monitor quality control. And importantly, develop an experimental specific QC protocols using beads and reference controls, such as cells. For further information, you can email us at support@expertcytometry.com. You can go to our website. Of course, you can get more information about the Expert Cytometry Mastery Class, the leading online flow cytometry training program, at getflowtraining.com. Thank you very much for listening. Best of luck in your flow cytometry experiments.